Hey everyone, my name is Dr. Galatia Strong. After getting a 100% on my NPTE, I co-founded SPT With Me, which is designed to help DPT students who are just about to take their NPTE actually understand material versus just trying to memorize everything. If you enjoy what you see, check out SPTWithMe.com for our 3 and 6 hour course. Now, onto what you're actually here for, let's talk about vertebrobasilar insufficiency. First of all, what is vertebrobasilar insufficiency, or VBI? Well, if you break it down, vertebro is for vertebral artery, basilar is for the basilar artery, and insufficiency means that there's a lack of oxygen to the brain. So essentially, it's an infarction to these specific arteries. Now, for the most part, I'm pretty sure, or at least I hope, that everyone understands that this is a very important condition to be knowledgeable about. Now, hopefully, once you hear this term, you should immediately associate it to 5 Ds and 3 Ns. You might have them all memorized, and that's fine. However, just understand that this is a very surface level way of learning something. You're not actually associating the anatomy and physiology behind it, but that's what this lecture is all about. We're going to try to make sense of what this condition is. Let's talk about anatomy first. Now, one of the hardest things about studying just in general is that we are often given information in chunks. So we're shown pictures of sections of the body versus a sequential route. So I want to break that pattern up. So we are going to start off with how the blood flows from the heart, going up the neck, and then into the brain, which is where this actually occurs. So let's start at the level of the heart. So we're going to go superiorly as the blood goes through the aorta, then to the subclavian arteries on the left and right side. And as we continue on, there's a branch that comes off the subclavian artery known as the vertebral artery. So this is one of the two arteries that we're talking about with respect to the vertebrobasilar artery. Now let's go down to the two pictures that we have at the bottom of the slide. Now sometimes people get this confused. What's depicted here are the two vertebral arteries, not the carotid arteries. The vertebral arteries actually go through the transverse foramen of the cervical spine. It's protected by bony matter, unlike the carotid arteries, which are not depicted here. So as we continue on and we go up, you're going to notice that the left and the right vertebral arteries merge at the top. And when they merge, this is called the basilar artery. So this is the other artery that's addressed with VBI. So even though they are technically two different arteries, they're just a continuation of each other. This is another view, and here you can actually put a person's face to it and you can see how the artery looks relative to the rest of the head and the neck. Here you can see that the basilar artery goes into the skull and supplies the CNS, the central nervous system. And in the next slide, we will talk about what the artery supplies. Before I even start talking about what this artery supplies, again, the most important thing about learning material is knowing exactly where you are within the body. This picture right here is something that you probably have been shown through school, whether it's something similar or the exact same picture. However, even though you know it's the brainstem and the cerebellum, can you actually put in place where exactly in the body it is? Well, here, these are placed at the very base of a person's skull, just superior to the foramen magnum. So onto the artery. As you can see, there are a ton of tiny little branches that come off the basilar artery. These branches supply the occipital lobe, the cerebellum, and the brainstem. Now, this is very important to know in helping you understand why the 5 Ds and 3 Ns actually make sense. It's finally time to make sense of these 5 Ds and 3 Ns, those terms that you just have to memorize. If there is something wrong with the occipital lobe, what would you expect to see? Probably visual changes, aka diplopia. If there's something wrong with the cerebellum, what would you expect to see then? Dizziness, nausea, slurring of words, aka dysarthria. Now, if there's something wrong with the brainstem, what would you expect to see? Unstable hemodynamics, etc. So hopefully, by thinking this way, you're starting to connect the dots. Now we know where it's happening, why it's happening, and what is happening. As a physical therapist, how do you test for it? Let's look at this diagram. If you look at the image on the left side of it is the posterior aspect of the cervical spine, and the right side of it is the anterior aspect of the cervical spine. So it's a lateral view. This is a picture of a neck in a neutral position, okay? If you look at the picture on the right side, this is the same neck, however, the person's head is rotated to the left. If you look at the highlighted spot, you can see that the artery is stretched out. So with cervical rotation, the artery stretches out. And why does this matter? Well, the thinner a tube, the harder it is for fluid within to get through. AKA blood cannot get through as well, meaning oxygen can't get through as well. Lack of oxygen means that the areas affected will not be working properly, thus you get the symptoms of the 5 Ds and 3 Ns. Now, not depicted in this figure, but you can really stretch out this artery when you also place the cervical spine in extension. So this really would limit oxygen to the brain if there's something wrong with the artery. So both extension and rotation. Okay, great. So both of these stretch out the artery. What about it? Why does it matter? We'll put the pieces together. What position would you put a patient in if you wanted to test for VBI? Your patient would be in supine and you'd place their cervical spine in extension and rotation. So it should make sense now. Great. One final thing, note that the side that you're testing is contralateral to the direction of cervical rotation. So if you look at this image, the highlighted image, it's of a person's neck rotated to the left. Thus, you would be stretching out and testing the right vertebral artery. Here are the references. Feel free to take a look at any and all of them. Very helpful. I really hope this lecture helped to clear some important pieces of information regarding this test and helps make sense of it. If you like this content, please check out our 3 and 6 hour mini NPTE course to help you figure out what you actually need to know for the exam.